I would like to talk about a drug that every single American, including the president, vice president, you, me, everyone including in this world, uses every single night. It's produced during REM sleep by our pineal gland. This drug is called DMT, dimethyltryptamine. Most people have no idea about it, some people have never heard of it, and the people who have used it do know what it's about. I personally have never used this drug, but I'm a free speaker and my opinions about a lot of things and why this drug should be illegal or legalized. Right now it falls under the Schedule 1 Act. Now it's controlled substance under hallucinogenic and it's listed in the U.S. Code of Federal Regulations, Title 21, Part 1308.11 of 1985. Now the funny thing about this is, it's a controlled substance so we're not allowed to use it, but everybody uses it. Every single night when you sleep, during REM sleep, your brain produces this drug naturally. So that means by U.S. law, we're all committing a crime, a federal crime, every single night when we sleep. When you walk around on the streets or go from city to city or drive your car to work, you're actually carrying this substance. So now you're part of the manufacturing supply of distributing it, except for you're not actually distributing it, you're just holding on to it while you walk around because this drug is constantly in your brain. This drug is also produced, like I said, in thousands of plants. Animals even produce this drug. The whole thing about, you know, you can lick a toad and you trip. That's what the drug is. It's dimethyltryptamine. Now, this drug has been used for over thousands of years. It was first synthesized as a modern record in 1931, and it was first demonstrated as a hallucinogen in 1956. Now, most people smoke it, and the effects only last between 5 and 10 minutes. And the average dosage is 20 to 40 milligrams depending on body weight and up. The stronger the dose, the less you remember from the actual experience itself. I'm not going to call it a trip because you don't actually go on a trip. What you do is you unlock a part of your brain that's there, but most of the time we don't see it. But most people don't want to look at hallucinogens as that way. But this isn't like most hallucinogens. This is occurring in your body every single time you go to sleep. So, like I said, from the president himself to the most religious, you know, advocate to you and me, we're all under the influence of this drug. Every single night since we've been a baby, when we hit REM sleep, we produce it. But it's a controlled one substance. That means that, one, it has a high potential for abuse. Two, the drug is not currently accepted for medical use treatments in the United States of America. And three, there's a lack of accepted safety for the use of this drug or other substances under medical supervision. Now let's look at this. There's never been any cases of addiction. This drug is not physically or mentally addictive at all. There's never been a death. There's never been any suicides. There's never been any murders. Call that up to the big pharmaceutical companies and see what they say about their products when it comes to that. But yet, those are legal and can be pushed to you every single day by your number one drug dealer, your doctor. But this cannot even be sold, bought, produced, or anything, but yet it's produced in nature and it's produced in your own human brain every single night. Now, the funny thing about this is it's a very simple chemical formula. It's actually, if you really want to get technical, it's C12, H16, and N2. Now, there's a cousin of the drug, as I like to call it, and that's called 5-MeO-DMT. It's basically just dimethyltryptamine with an oxygen atom attached to it. Now, that one is not as safe, and you don't have as strong of visual effects as you do with DMT. So I recommend that if you are going to use one of these, you only use DMT. There is no side effects, and there is no negative consequences of this drug. You can use it pretty much every single day for the rest of your life as much as you want, and it will not mess up your brain. Once again, it's because your brain produces it naturally. But once again, it's illegal somehow. So why don't they want you to use this drug? Well, in my opinion, there's two main reasons. One is the pharmaceutical companies have not found a way to profit from it. Well, that's pretty easy to understand considering you can go out with a simple chemistry set and extract this stuff from grass. So how would they control it? It's not like they're making it in a lab and pushing it to you. And two is because you have a profound spiritual experience. Most people who use this drug do not want to commit crime. They don't want to commit murder. They don't want, you know, basically to fuck up their lives. But yet the government, something as peaceful as this, does not even support it at all. They will actually arrest you if you're in possession of this. Then that's fine with me, but you need to go arrest the president, the vice president, Congress, the Senate, and everybody else because they all have this drug right now on their body. It's already going to be used tonight when they go to sleep. Their brains are going to produce it. They're going to be under the influence. So why don't we arrest everybody in the whole world, most animal species, and just get it over with? What else is there to do? But here's a really funny thing, though. There's a guy named Dr. Rick Strassman. He did a lot of research with this, and I do recommend everybody read his book. It's called DMT, The Spirit Molecule. You can even find some stuff on YouTube, audio with him on it, from Coast to Coast AM, and so forth and so forth. But this drug's also been used in many countries under the supervision of medical staff for treating alcoholism and heroin addiction. There's been multiple, and I mean hundreds upon hundreds of cases, if not into the tens of thousands, where a heroin addict can take one dose of this and decide to give up heroin for the rest of their life because they realize that life is too short to be hooked on a substance like heroin. And the same thing goes for alcoholics. This drug has been used many of times for the exact same thing. But yet in America, we can't find any usage for it, where drug addiction is basically just appalling. A recent study showed that 16% of sixth graders had already began drinking alcohol in the United States, but yet this drug is sold on every single corner. And remember that, alcohol is a drug. It's pushed on every single corner in every single store. Don't get me wrong, before I was 21, you know, I'm sure just like everybody else, I've had a drink before. It's not that hard to understand. But this is simple. Dimethyltryptamine is something that we should all experience. We do every single night. We need to write our congressman. We need to do something, but I really shouldn't say write our congressman because we all know that doesn't do shit in America. We need to stand up and just tell them, this needs to be legal, you're under the influence as much as I am, and stop this bullshit. Now, I don't want to cause anybody to sit there and go, well, you know, it's just a hallucinogenic drug and there is no use for it. No, there is a lot of use for it. Shamans have used this thing for thousands of years. These are people who could live off nature without any help from anybody else. Let me see most Americans go out into nature and do that. These are people who understood things before they even happened. This isn't just a drug that makes you go on a trip. This is a drug that your brain naturally produces and likes. So why is it being basically made illegal worldwide? They don't want you to know. So you have to ask yourself, as a human, as an individual entity, what don't they want me to experience? If my brain produces this naturally, and it's abundant through nature, why is it illegal? To all you Christians, they're basically saying that, you know, if you believe in God, and they believe that, you know, God created the plants and herbs of this world, they're making that illegal. But you don't care about that. Nobody cares. That's the problem with this whole situation. Everybody lets them do what they want to do, when they want to do it, and they get away with it. No one even understands what they're doing. Most people you talk to will never have an idea what DMT is or what it can do. Please stand up and get this stuff taken care of. Stop the FDA from pushing bad pharmaceutical drugs that destroy your brain. You're depressed? Smoke some DMT. It's worked in thousands of cases. It's cured depression. These drugs are not drugs. These are natural uses. I don't care if you're a Christian, if you're an atheist, if you're a Buddhist, if you're a Muslim, what you are. This is naturally occurring. Use it. Stop letting people that have no care for your own life telling you what you can and cannot put in your body when every single night they're using the drug. Thank you.